Conor McGregor. The celebrities are out. The floor seats are packed because the notorious one, Conor McGregor, makes his triumphant return here tonight. There's always a special feel when a UFC main event is about to unfold, but Conor McGregor just takes it to that requisite next level.
J.A., as a fan, I usually sit right next to the octagon, but when Conor fights, I got to be in the first row behind the barrier because the celebrities are out in droves. Conor McGregor has this thing about him that makes everybody want to show up. They flock to Vegas. They come in groups. They want to experience the notorious Conor McGregor. They want to see if he can have one of those special moments, him atop the cage, him knocking out Jose Aldo. If you experience the McGregor experience, you always have a story to tell, and that's why people show up.
He's going to cash the check tonight, right? But he's not here for just money, This is about proving himself, trying to improve his mixed martial arts legacy. One, two titles, no title defenses. That's a big part of the motivation.
He takes a lot of pride in the preparation to getting to the octagon, and you see it every time Conor McGregor fights.
All right, so here he is representing the American Kickboxing Academy, the inimitable Khabib Nurmagomedov, and this guy makes his way to the octagon, DC. You run out of time setting up everything he's accomplished, but he always puts that status as an undefeated fighter and UFC champion on the line. He will do so again here tonight.
The moment he walked into AKA, you understood that there was something special about Nurmagomedov. He was a guy that was always listening, although he spoke no English. He was always listening and paying attention to try to learn and how to improve himself. And the moment he stepped foot in the gym, he was just open to each and every lesson, and now it's showing over the course of his UFC career. He was undefeated going into the UFC, and he has only built on that and become a champion, one of the most well-rounded fighters in all of the UFC.
You know, your college wrestling teammates have told me when you showed up at Oklahoma State, you didn't speak English either.
No, I didn't. It was all Southern Creole accent. It was all, hey, my boy.
Right. Well, your English is now very proper, and so is Khabib's, and he's back on the proven ground here tonight, again trying to prove himself as one of the pound-for-pound greatest fighters on this UFC roster.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 22 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Dublin, Ireland, the notorious Conor McGregor! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a grappler holding a professional record of 29 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of the Republic of Dagestan, Russia, Khabib the Eagle Nurmagomedov! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our third man in the octagon for this one.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, so the rematch is upon us. Khabib Nurmagomedov versus Conor McGregor. Got to think both sides might change some things up here in advance of the second round.
You have to make adjustments if you're going to be successful in a rematch. No two fights are the same, so you have to approach it as if you guys have never fought before. I know that the Mega Battle Camp has made adjustments.
Oh, yeah, right hand.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, you know he's comfortable fighting off of his back. Both fighters get up now.
If you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head.
Oh, nice connection with that punch. It's one thing to have an edge in reach. It's another to take advantage. Nicely done.
Let's go. Let's get the takedown.
Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone.
reaction there from McGregor, DC.
I mean, big strike landed for Ireland's favorite son, Conor McGregor.
And there comes the separation now. Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job.
So just over 20 total strikes have now landed for Khabib Nurmagomedov. Nurmagomedov's kick looked like it might have been a good one, but it gets blocked. Oh, nice pop there from the crowd as he finally gets the takedown. He stayed committed to the offensive wrestling, and now he has his... Now looking to do something with that left arm.
He's isolating the Kimura attack. Notice he'll pick up his left leg, step over the head. Once he gets him on his side, he'll start to apply pressure to try to get the finish. The Kimura's not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by McGregor. Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it. And you are seeing why. He's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
Conor McGregor gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. 30 seconds to go. Oh, that's a good right hand. 20 seconds to go.
Oh, big elbow.
Body closes the distance. Gets
take
the
down, cover. Side. Take down, cover. Over and over. He secured these takedowns.
All right, so there's the horn. That means it's the end of the round. And get that man a singlet, man, right? Offensive wrestling on point tonight.
That was a tutorial. That was every single takedown you could secure in a fight. He did it all the right way. He's beating his opponent to the finish before he can try to sprawl and respond. He's a step behind. If he's going to stop these takedowns going forward, he needs to react a little quicker.
All right, so we'll see how it goes here in this round. Previous round, it was all him just taking his opponent down, really every time he entered.
Yeah, every time he got in on the leg, he was able to secure a finish. And that is the idea you want as a wrestler going into a fight. If you have to change up the technique, it's fine. It's not always going to be the very first attack. When it's the first attack, you're very happy. But most times, you got to chain things together if you want to take down a great fighter.
And we know how hard it is to maintain the wrestling, right? The hours required in the gym to make sure that wrestling's still at a high level. He's putting in the time.
Yes, he's putting in the time. And also, you see it in his movements. When he gets to an attack, he's constantly shifting positions. He's constantly moving his opponent. He's constantly trying to give him too much information to process.
Right.
And that comes from a lifetime of wrestling. If he just started this, it would be very difficult to trick his opponent. But now, by giving him so many different looks, he's been able to secure takedown after takedown after takedown.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here. Now the guy's got armbar. He's attacking it on it.
Squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice.
Look at the skip action that allows you to land that big knee.
Oh, and he lands another takedown here, just doing a nice job not telegraphing his shot. Clean entries. The Olympian's got to like what he sees.
I mean, over and over, he gets to the legs before his opponent reacts by beating him on the entry. Now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look from the transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Nice job using his
sounds. Okay, now he can escape.
Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom.
I need you to scramble, scramble.
All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Conor. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground.
Oh, McGregor's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
Leg kick.
Holy, big knee to the body.
How about
that
those 5 minutes?
All right, so the takedown's the big storyline in that previous round. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC, and got to be pretty discouraging to get grounded that many times in one round.
Oh, it's so discouraging because all you want to do is let your offense go, but every time you're getting dragged to the floor constantly, you're starting to get fatigued. He's starting to wear on you. Let's see what type of effect it takes on his offensive approach as the next round starts.
All right, we'll see how it goes here in this round. He had a big effort there in round one. Really had the wrestling on full display.
John, if he was looking to come out here, secure takedown, to feel good about the way...
It's over!
Now he's on top of him looking for the finish.
Side control now. A lot of top pressure being applied here. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
McGregor ground and pound from half guard now.
All right, closed guard now. You got to be careful, though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back.
Back to the feet now. A little single collar tie there. And they separate. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Thus far, 81 total strikes have now landed for Conor McGregor. Well, and more often than not, when it's been thrown, it has landed a 73% accuracy rate against Khabib Nurmagomedov. Oh, really using his reach advantage as he landed the jab there. Nurmagomedov gets in the clinch. Under 3 minutes now to go in the fight. And he landed the right hand there. Nurmagomedov gets the double leg takedown. How good was that? Well, not ideal to spend this much time on the bottom, but you can't fault him for his activity.
Now he's a tight triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Strikes here, and if you're the opponent, you've got to intelligently defend or the referee's going
to
stop.
Got to defend, but you can see him now start to gain posture, and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
Oh, these are some heavyweight hammer fists here. We'll see if he can finish the job.
He's landing every one of these strikes with full intensity, with full intent to end the night of his opponent.
All right, got to be careful playing around inside his guard.
Absolutely, John. That's why you don't sit in a full guard. When you sit in a full guard, it gives these guys too many opportunities to chase submissions. And now he's jumping on a triangle.
Oh, collar tie. He's trying to establish that jab once again.
All right, so as we await the judges' scorecards, DC will look back at his handiwork. He had it all going from a striking standpoint tonight.
Man, he did a great job. It was very entertaining to watch someone be in such a great state of flow, a great flow state in regards to the stand-up. He said that tonight we would be very impressed with his performance, and I am thoroughly impressed.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest 9-28. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Khabib the Eagle Nurmagomedov.
All right, nice job
He is your winner via unanimous decision. And sometimes I would think it's easier said than done.